Hi, I'm Dan Miller with Livernois Motorsport. Thanks for watching our videos. We got here is a 2020 Explorer ST. We're super excited about this. This thing for 2020 has an all-new engine, new drivetrain. This is a 3-liter, 400 horsepower. That's pretty big, so we're really excited. I think everybody knows Livernois Motorsports is known for EcoBoost tuning, so we're one of the first to get our hands on one of these. We're going to be the first to tune this thing. This engine is a little different than the last engine. This one is mounted longitudinal versus the old one was transverse like a front-wheel drive car. So this car's got a transfer case in it. It's got a shaft in it going to the front wheels. A little different design. We're really excited about this. It's starting off 35 horsepower more than the old Explorer Sport did. So 400 horsepower, it's pretty exciting. So we're gonna go ahead and do some baselines on this thing, do some tuning on it. And so if you watch the video here, we'll show you what we can do with this brand new platform. Okay, we got our 2020 Explorer ST on the dyno. We made some baseline pulls with it. This thing put down some pretty good power. It was 320 horsepower and almost 400 foot-pounds. Pretty impressive for this thing being a brand new vehicle, not a lot of miles on it. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna work on the calibration, try to get something, let's call it maybe our stage one cal. We're gonna work on it, see what kind of power we can get out of this. Hopefully this is like the older Explorers. We can get 40, 50, 60 horsepower out of a tune. So stay tuned, we're gonna put the tune in it, run it, we'll report back. Okay, we loaded our tune, we made some pulls on this thing. This thing is actually really impressive. It picked up almost 40 horsepower peak to peak. It picked up over 50 horsepower if we ignore the peaks and some different parts throughout the runs, and 40 foot-pounds of torque. Really impressive. This is our preliminary dyno results for this. There will be some updates going forward because this is a brand new vehicle, brand new engine, new platform. So we're not going to lean on it super hard. So we'll probably do some development on it. But for right now, this is where we want to stay. We've also addressed our 10-speed shifting, which if you've seen my F-150 and Mustang videos, we've made those shift sequentially. This thing's no different than anything else Ford's making on 10-speed. It does shift 1 to 3, 3 to 5, not sequential. Not sure why, it's a 10-speed and we don't use all 10 speeds, but we do correct that in the calibration. And stay tuned for some other dyno stuff and look forward to this platform going forward.